Hi, welcome back. If you're planning on installing FreeBSD 10 on VMware's ESXi hypervisor, specifically the 5X versions, and you want to install the VMware Tools, you've come to the right place. Right out of the box, the VMware Tools doesn't quite install correctly, and a very generous person provided some patches, and this will allow you to be able to recompile them and actually get them to work. So the details are in the description. So I created a script to automate that install process. So go to a link just right above me, you'll find a download link there. The script will automatically install all the necessary ports and patches that VMware Tools needs. It'll automatically take the patches and recompile everything for you and then kick off the VMware Tools install script. My script assumes that you're starting off with a fresh install of FreeBSD and that the machine that you loaded on has internet access. So I'm going to quickly walk you through how to set up a VM and a fresh install of FreeBSD. I've already logged into the vSphere client and I'm going to create a new virtual machine using a custom configuration. This one is going to be my future web server, so I'm naming it accordingly. You can name it whatever you want. Depending on how you have your storage set up, pick whatever makes sense for you. Go ahead and pick version 8. For guest operating systems, click Other. And since I'm using a 64-bit machine, I'm going to select FreeBSD 64-bit. For CPU and memory settings, pick something that makes sense for you. Select the VMX Net3 adapter. FreeBSD 10 already has support for it. Also select the appropriate network that will give it internet access. For these next three screens, pick whatever settings make sense for you. When you're done, go ahead and check the box to edit the VM settings. Generally, I like to remove the floppy disk drive. I don't need it. Next, select the DVD drive, and then select the data store ISO file option. I've already downloaded the FreeBSD 10 ISO and uploaded it to ESXi. Now I just have to browse for it. Once selected, check Connect at Power On. The machine will then boot to the DVD so we can proceed with the install. Click Install. At this screen, you'll need to install the source code. You need it to recompile the VM tools. These are my recommended selections. When you get to this point, make sure you configure the interface so you can reach the internet. Once installation is complete, go ahead and reboot and log in as root. Through the console menu, go ahead and start the install for VMware Tools. It just puts an ISO file into the CD drive. The script will take care of mounting the CD ISO for you. Now is probably a good time to transfer the script with the method of your choosing. I suggest using WinSCP or some other SCP utility. Remember, you have to toggle the execute bit on the script first. If you're installing this on ESXi 5.5, you need to add the -5.5 option at the end. Otherwise, with versions 5.0 and 5.1, no options are needed. During the course of the script, you'll see these menus. I generally go with the defaults. What you're seeing here at the bottom is the beginning of the VMware supplied install script. Everything likely worked if you got to this point. With the questions, I went with the defaults. At this point, everything is complete. If everything is working correctly, you should see the green checkmark next to the VMware tools in the summary tab. If you want more details, I also put together an extended version of this video with live commentary. It shows the entire process from start to finish. To see it, click the annotation on the left or the link in the description.